Hey, what's going on, guys, and welcome back. Today we're going to be discussing a topic I've seen brought up quite a bit ever since the announcement of Nexomon 1 on consoles, that being whether or not you should play Nexomon 1 before Nexomon Extinction, or vice versa. This video will be exploring both angles to this and discussing what the implications are should you play one game first or the other. That said, make sure to sit back, relax, and let's dive right in. Okay, so let's get one thing out of the way. Yes, Nexomon Extinction is a sequel to Nexomon 1, so the general consensus when this fact is taken at face value is to play Nexomon when it comes out first, and then head on over to Nexomon Extinction. That said, in all actuality, it's not as cut and dry as one might think, since while the game is indeed a sequel, it's a sequel in the same way that Pokemon Gold and Silver are sequels to Pokemon Red and Blue. There are various references to past characters and events the same way that Gold and Silver do the exact same thing. That said, you can absolutely play Gold and Silver before Red and Blue the same way you could play Nexomon Extinction before Nexomon 1. Sure, some references may go over your head, however, nothing of extreme importance needs to be known before heading into Extinction. You won't get lost on the story or anything like that if you play Extinction first, and if you do play Nexomon Extinction first, when you go to play Nexomon 1, you'll be like, oh yeah, I know that guy, or I know that place, so you'll actually have the references in mind, but in reverse order. Now that said, there are some definite advantages to playing the original first, as far as experiencing the story goes especially. For one, you'll know certain people by name and already have an idea of what they're up to given their history in Nexomon 1, and you'll understand exactly who the ghost you meet isn't at the beginning of the game if it wasn't already pretty obvious. Not to mention, you'll also have a basic understanding of how the gameplay works in terms of the battle system, and all you'll need to do is learn about cores and readjust your perspective with how rarity works in regards to evolution, but all in all, you'll feel like someone who is coming off of Red and Blue going into Gen 2 with prior knowledge of the game's systems and open to learning new concepts and features. Conversely, playing the first Nexomon before the second will actually take away some of the surprise reveals, since you already know the identity of certain people before it's explicitly revealed in-game. This could be seen as a negative, as it'll make parts of the story a lot more predictable, and I can definitely say that me personally, being someone who played Extinction first, and I've got to say I thoroughly enjoyed all of the twists and turns, and knowing what I know now, I do realize that I would have been a lot less shocked by certain facts if I had played the first originally. There's also another sort of double-edged sword, so to speak, regarding which game to play in terms of the implications it can have on the franchise as well. So Nexomon 1, as I stated in this video, is a lot less jam-packed with nuance than the sequel. Cores, cosmic forms, backsprites, psychic and ghost types, and more were not present during the original Nexomon and were added as improvements into Nexomon Extinction and are now pretty much staples of the series. Because of this, I can see two disadvantages to playing either game first, depending on the person, and this likely won't have any sort of major impact on the franchise because both games are still awesome, but in the case where someone plays Nexomon Extinction first, they may expect Nexomon 1 to be up to the same standard in terms of features and various other aspects, but the thing is that Nexomon 1 is a port of a game that came out 3 years before Extinction. Extinction takes everything Nexomon has and makes it better and improves on the formula, much like Gen 2 Pokemon did to Gen 1. Like I said, I don't think this could cause any major disappointment or backlash or anything like that, but it may be considered a step back to some people as opposed to a step forward if they don't fully understand what the implications of the game being a port are. On the flip side, if you play Nexomon 1 first and aren't familiar with all of the upgrades that Extinction holds, it may distort your opinion of the whole franchise and may cause some individuals to not try Extinction because they felt like Nexomon 1 was lacking in, let's say, evolutions for common Nexomon, or cosmic forms, or held items, or something like that. All of this goes back to the video that I just mentioned, talking about Nexomon 1 and what not to expect, and how it's not going to be a more nuanced game than Nexomon Extinction, but you should enjoy it at face value as a prequel. The thing is, Jay Vemin and the P-Cube team were listening to fans who really wanted Nexomon 1 on console, and they're delivering. Okay, so I've basically established that both ways have their pros and cons, but what do I think the best way to play is? Well, firstly, let's consider context. Nexomon 1 is still about a month away as of the time this video will be going live, and that's a long time to wait just so you could play the first one, despite the games not really requiring you to play them in order. Also, you might feel a little burned out going from one game right to another, so there's that as well. Also, not to mention the story stuff being more obvious and gathering less shock factor if you've played the first. That said, I can also understand wanting to play the second game with all the references from the first in mind so you don't miss them, but I do think I came up with a pretty good way to play these games as of right now if you're really looking to get the best of both worlds, if you will. So here it is. Buy Nexomon Extinction. It's awesome. You can check out this review for more info, but I think you should play Extinction now and enjoy it while you wait for Nexomon 1. This will allow you to familiarize yourself with the Nexomon formula and tie you over until you get to play the prequel. When the prequel comes out, you can then enjoy that alongside some spicy Gym Leader Ed videos that will explore all the major aspects of the game, of course. After you've beaten Nexomon 1, maybe give yourself some time so you don't feel too burnt out or whatever, but you can go back to Nexomon Extinction via the custom mode. I did a whole video discussing custom mode as well, but this mode allows for randomized Nexomon, Nuzlocks, insane levels, random items, etc., and is an entirely different way to experience the same game without it feeling too stale. This will allow the player to truly experience Nexomon Extinction with and without the references in mind, without feeling like they're playing the same game twice. Since custom mode adds an insane amount of replayability to the game, I do think this is a great way to sort of revisit the story after you've learned more from Nexomon 1. I really do think that this is the best case scenario for the player, so long as they keep in mind the context of Nexomon 1 being a previous title to Extinction rather than a prequel that just happened to launch after. That said, if you haven't played either game, how do you plan on tackling them? If you have played Extinction or are playing it now, let me know what your thoughts are so far and what you're looking forward to. If you did enjoy this video or are a fan of monster taming and or Nexomon content, definitely make sure to like and subscribe for more. You can follow me on Twitter at GymLeaderEd. You can check out my Discord, my Patreon, and my Twitch channel, all links in the description. Thanks so much for watching, guys. I'll see you next time. Peace.